Everybody, it's Chris, and I've got a birthday review for the Blue Collar Beer Gentleman. This is going to be kind of precarious because I'm at a position right now where the sun is hitting my neighbor's window and blinding me. So, a couple of times here, I'm probably going to look like Casper the Friendly Ghost because I'm going to turn all white. But I'm going to try and keep this position in such a way that you can just see my usual ruddy face. Today is my 47th birthday, and I had actually chosen a beer when I was last at the grocery store, not the grocery store, the bottle shop. And I was thinking of using this particular beer from my birthday review, and then my good buddy Tony hooked me up with the beer, which I think is actually the better option. For one, this beer is a gift, which makes it a perfect birthday beer. For two, it is called Today Years Old, and it is a, let's see if we get this in there without the glare. You can see everything. There we go. Yes, the beer is called Today Years Old. It is a New England IPA. It's made by Bad Beat Brewing. Bad Beat Brewing is a brewer here in Las Vegas. They are a local brewer. They're actually technically in the city of Henderson, Nevada, which is a suburb of Las Vegas. They haven't been around for too long. I don't think they've been around a full 5 years, maybe five, but not more than that. But this particular beer has a 7% ABV. IBUs are unavailable. It was released in April of 2019, and the proceeds of this beer actually go to the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. So Tony not only got me a gift, but he got me a gift with some value to it because it's a gift where proceeds went to help those in need. So good thing all around. Only one of my friends on Untappd has reviewed this beer. He gave it a 4.0. 230 of us cumulatively have given it a 3.75. Beer Advocate has no ranking, has no reviews, no rankings, nothing. It used Southern Passion and Centennial hops, and the oats used were Two Row, Carrapils, and Flaked Oats. So there you have it. There's the ins and outs of that. I am going to be using, as usual, my Tenaya Creek IPA glass. Just a quick shout out to Tenaya Creek, because whenever I drink a local IPA, I like to drink it out of this glass because it is a local brewery. And I've got a hummingbird that almost seems like he's casing me. Anyway, quick shout out to Tenaya Creek. If you go into Tenaya Creek on a Tuesday, like today, today's a Tuesday, why not go down there and drink some beer in my honor? But yes, you slap down $6 on the counter at Tenaya Creek on a Tuesday. You're gonna get a glass just like this. It's gonna be full of house beer. You go back when your glass is empty, slap down $5, you're gonna get refills. That night, take the glass home with you, wash it, bring it back next Tuesday. Guess what? More $5 refills on that same glass. Until the damn thing breaks, it's yours to keep refilling at $5 a pop. And if you can find a stick that can beat that deal, I want to see that stick. So anyway, getting to this, there is, as I said, this was released in April. There is no canned on date or enjoy by date. It was released in April. So what is that? April is the fourth month. April is the cruelest month. I remember that. So yeah, this is a 3-month-old beer. So as an IPA, that's perfect. And I'm going to show you how this is pouring. Nice and golden. Very light. Not quite as hazy as I was expecting a New England beer to be. A New England IPA. In fact, this is okay, yeah, I see the cloudiness now. I guess because, see, the deal is I've actually got sunlight hitting this. And guys, what you're seeing is, oh, at least two shades, possibly three shades darker than the actual color of the beer. But because I have genuine sunlight coming through, I'm getting lots and lots of light. See, down here at the bottom, it's not quite as hazy as it is up at the top. I'm going to describe that carbonation, though, as medium high. It's plenty of carbonation. As you can see, this head doesn't seem to be going anywhere. I'm gonna give this a quick beard wipe, see what I come across. And hops is what I smell mostly, but if I stick my schnoz directly in, see what I can find. Very, very fruity, but not even really citrus fruit. Well, I guess are peaches considered citrus? I've heard an argument on both sides saying that they are and that they aren't, but. Very fruity, very hoppy. I'm expecting a lot of hop juice in this. So there we go. There's some sediment. That's looking good. That's what I want to see. I don't know if you can see. No, you really can't see that, can you? You can kind of see some of it sinking to the bottom. That's what I was really looking for. Some of that beautiful any IPA sediment. So I'm going to quit yapping my flap, and considering it's my birthday, I'm going to drink this damn beer. So cheers to me. Well, it's refreshing, I give you that. It's not overly bitter, it's not overly sweet, not overly creamy. It's okay. I think 3.75 is actually about fair. In fact, I think it might even be a little bit generous. Yeah, I've had better I've had better IPAs from Bad Beat. I'm thinking this is gonna get a I'm gonna give it a 3.25. It gets the extra 0.25 for being in a can, but all in all, I am not impressed with this beer. Doesn't mean I don't appreciate it, Tony. I appreciate it immensely. It was a great gift, and I appreciate it. But I'm just I don't know. There's not a lot of flavor to this. It's only it's only 3 months old, and I'm sorry. I thought I was having a problem with my speaker, but I don't think I am now. And hopefully, this isn't the first word you're hearing me say on this review. Otherwise, my speaker was in fact having a problem, or my microphone. No, me, my speaker. Yeah. Okay. So I don't know. I'm not thrilled about this beer. I gotta say. Finally, get it to come in. There we go. Today, years old. I'm always glad to help out an institution that needs help, like the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. And I'm glad Tony, if he bought a beer, that the money went to a good cause. But guys, I'm not impressed with this beer. I think 3.25 is plenty. But don't let this keep you from Bad Beat's beers. Bad Beat makes great beers, and if you're here in Las Vegas, tell your Uber driver or your taxi driver that you're looking for the Brewery District, and there you'll find Bad Beat, as well as Astronomy Ale Works, another great brewery. It's just around the corner from Bad Beat. I mean, you could park in one spot and be equidistant to both breweries. That's how close they are to each other. So, guys, if you like this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Pardon, excuse me. And until next time, drink good beer and don't break the bank doing it. And cheers to me on my birthday.